And we finally, someone convinced him to give us 5 minutes at a coffee shop. We gave him the model, he came back a week later and said this is different because we put him first, we put him racing at the core of the model. And we were lucky enough to find a great partnership.
Look, our motto at the agency is brands don't sell homes, people do. Right? So, and obviously, the same philosophy before. We work for our agents. That's how we look. You're our customers in terms of our agency, and that your vendors and your customers. Yeah. So that's a different shift in CLA. So our A is predicated on this. First of all, it's a rising peak thing trade wise. So that's some signed off by a master. The other thing is it's vendor, purchaser, agent. That's the trilogy of it, right? So that's where how it works. That's the design of the A, right? We keep it the agency. The reason the name is because the agents can build their own business and people, all our agents go to the market and say, oh, congratulations, you got your open ocean. It's not Ray White, Matt LaFleur, or it's not, you know, Place or whatever the name's up here, Coronas. It's not someone else's name. It's just the agency. So you can brand it the agency, Matt LaFleur, and then all of a sudden people think you actually own the business. But it's how we operate. Right, so effectively, when I saw the plan with Paul, we looked at how we could see the market was changing. We could see the franchise world was completely shifting. This franchise C in the middle, like I interviewed probably 300 plus agencies. And one of the first things I was asking them is, what do you get for your 10%, like your pay or otherwise, whatever it is, or a Booker's or a Rain? I'm not thinking on anyone here, right? And they go, well, not really. So who do they give you leads? No. So bingo here, right? So they give you training and coaching. No. What are you actually paying for your 10%? They go, oh, it's just the brand. No, I said, brands don't sell us, people do. How many leads do you get off the brand? We don't get any leads, at least the one place. So when I started drilling down, we knew that was going to go eventually. So the franchise model is under threat across Australia. We've proven that one. Because in models that are agile like ours, yours and ours, we can just open up tomorrow in Brisbane. We were heading towards Brisbane. I just, by chance, Paul and I met. And I said, well, we're about to launch hard into Brisbane and then, you know, eventually build that. So we've got the contacts here of the really solid brand agents that have been waiting for us to come up here. So we thought, look, we started talking about what's possible. I looked at Paul's algorithms and the leads. You guys have got a lot of stuff we don't have. And we've got some things that we might be able to add value, which is branding, coaching, mentoring. My expertise is building superstars. I start from the start and where they start. And I believe you can use any agent to follow our plan, you'll triple your income in 2 years' time. And Thomas has worked with me for 8 years. We've worked with some of the best, biggest people in Brisbane, the biggest names in real estate, started them from nothing. And when I say nothing, in terms of doing small numbers, and I can tell you the biggest thing I find out of coaching some of the biggest riders in Australia is 90% of his mindset. So I've sat with plenty of agents and they argue with me. I say, look, I look at their business, I look at how good they are, and I can see some sharp people in this room. And if I start drilling, they're doing a quarter of what they could be doing. And all they need to know is how, right? And the how is process. It's really simple, but it's mindset, because a lot of the people I speak to, they say, I can't write, no one in Brisbane's writing $1 million. That was the thing I got when I first came. I said, why don't you be the first one?
Mindset.
It's like the person that broke the 4 minute mile or whatever it was, right? Mindset. Someone was going to do it. There's always going to be someone that's going to break the record. A racehorse came around in Australia that won 18 horses in weeks, right? Everyone's heard of weeks. Won all these, but no horse had done that before. This was down. Someone's going to come and probably win 20 after that.
Oh, Ben.
So the first person, this thing was up to this. Yeah. All right. Put a few people in there. Can we open these windows?
I didn't think
so. No, I
didn't
think so.
Should have asked
you to see that one. All right. Let's not try and see here. The first thing is, we're going to run this like an option. Come on in. Grab a paddle. Grab a paddle.
Hi,
thanks for making it. We've got air conditioning on here. We'll get some water. I think we're right for it.
Actually, you're meeting with that in your place now. You're a beautiful place. Beautiful place. We're parking too.
beautiful venue. We have a model which is similar to yours. We have docking stations, right? We just don't have a, and that's why I really resonated. First of all, I haven't actually said about before, I spent an hour with him and I went back on the plane, my head was spinning about what's possible, because I think we've got some great things we're doing, but what Paul's done single-handedly, I've got some serious people around us here. Paul's done this and built this amazing setup with the algorithms and the lead gen. And my guys would be just loving having access to that. And it's sort of like in the thinking that's here is brilliant. And I just said to Paul, I've got it. We have to work out how we can potentially work together, right? So there's got to be 1 + 1 = 11 in our book. It doesn't equal 2. So if we can put 2 brains together, 1 + 1 = 11 exit. We agree on that. So that's the thinking. So we're going to work out. Smart guys in the room will work out that. I won't be many how we can work together, but we'll do. We're going to walk through this today to give you a sense of where we're at. Because I think one of the biggest things in the next 2 years, the agents that are the nimblest, low overheads, the sharpest in what they're doing is speed. Speed is the new currency, right? Speed is the new currency. If you're too slow, I'm going to show you something. Actually, I'm going to fast forward to a slide. I might get. Is this the best way to do this?
Yep.
You know what? I'm going to stand in front of that screen.
You
want to sit here? One of my favourite slides. Can I just end there for it?
Just
touch me. Yeah, that's what you're doing. Honored to have a photo finish. Can you scroll it up?
Oh, it's good.
Yeah. See that? That's my favourite slide. Right? That's the Melbourne Cup, right, effectively. The difference between that and that in prize money, have a guess the difference. There's about $4 million. Right? That's personifies to me real estate where it is today.
And third horse in that you can't see.
Can anyone see the third horse? Have a look. Yeah, got it. Come on in. Welcome. So the moral of this story, real estate now, in my view, today, as we sit here in 2019 in August, is a game of inches. You can be that far away from losing your listing and the commission. So there's, now, I don't know, average commission here, we call it, say, 15,000 for gross. Yeah? Call it 15, call it 20. What we want to leave you today with and get the thinking, you've got to always just be that nose in front of someone else. Because you can be that, you could, how many people thought they've had the listing and been told the next day they lost it? Hands up in the room. That's happened anyway? Yep. Okay, so that's what happens. And you could, if you've missed it, if you've missed that listing, 9 times out of 10 it's been because of that. So what? It's a game of inches, this business. So what we have to do is every little 1% thing we do, it could be the speed we get back to clients. It could be the speed we get back. I'm going to talk about, I was telling Paul before, one of the biggest strategies we implement in our business and told our top agents to do, and I told everybody to do actually, and our top agents execute, why we love working with them, come back to the office on a Saturday and do your callbacks, or go home or wherever you're working from, and do your callbacks on a Saturday, not on the Monday. Monday is here, right? That's the agent doing the callbacks on Monday. Because this agent's got their nose in front of the listing. On last count, 20% of people coming through an open house, what were they doing? Thinking of what?
Buying.
Thinking of?
They're looking at other properties as well on a Saturday. So
what else were they doing? All right answers, but not the one I'm looking for. 20% of people coming to an open house were thinking of what? What were they researching to do? Sell. Thank you. Right?
Yeah.
With me?
Yeah.
So if you're doing your callbacks on Monday, you're up at your competitors are picking up those listings on Saturday. Mm-hmm. If you do them on Saturday, you're going to unearth the reason why they've come through. We think they're all coming through to buy.
No.
How many of those buyers have come through?
You're right, 20%.
All right, 20%.
Because you don't know who lives in the street.
Exactly.
Around
right.
The corner.
And you know those ones that see they're just looking? They're the ones that are selling.
Exactly. Right. Yeah, exactly.
You with me? Everyone's got me now? Okay. This is where we're going to talk about this. No, it's okay. So we might just go
back up.
Yeah, no, thanks, mate. So just to this slide, I want to talk about today. You might go to the screen first if you don't want it.
I'm going to come up today. I'm going to give, these are the things I'm going to give you real stuff to go away with today that just might help. So, like, full of blockages to success, right? Everyone's got a pen and paper or phone to write something down, or take a photo or whatever. I just, Paul's got the, I think that when you write these things down or put them in, they mentally go in. That's my view. I've got slides, I've got to unwind. And what we don't want is Paul sent this to your computer. We don't want a whole lot of smart computers with nothing, you know, or smart desks with notes in it that we don't read. So let's read them when we leave. Okay. Here we go. So I'm not going to embarrass anyone, but who's got an ideal week, month, and year? Anyone? I'll turn around. Okay, a hand up. Okay, one hand in the room. Okay, so ideal week, ideal month, ideal year. I'm going to get real hard here because our job and the way we're going to talk, you can see what we're made about. We want to go from, who'd like to write $1 million in the next 12 months? Hands up. Just get to it. Leave the hands up if you think you can do it. Okay, beautiful. I'm working with the right crowd. Right? Who's writing $1 million now? Okay, so who's writing 500? Okay, so there's a bit of a gap. Yeah? Who's writing 300? 200? Okay, where am I stopping? There's a bit of a gap. There's a bit of honesty. Okay, right. So it looks like there's a bit of room for improvement here. Do we agree on that? Excited. It's a crowd I'm working with. Oh, good. So if I'm going to drive from here to New Farm and I don't know Brisbane and I'm going to get in the car and I've got a GPS, what am I going to do? I'm going to put from here to New Farm with a GPS. Do we agree with that?
Yep.
I'm going to get in the car and I'm going to start driving to the New Farm. What's the GPS going to do if I turn left or should I turn right?
Tell me.
It's going to say right. I top this. I'm going to skip. That's your ideal week I'm talking about. Right? Mm. So what I want you to do with an ideal week, I'm not going to complicate this, really simple. What are the things we all know we have to do as agents? Listing presentations, callbacks, vendor reports, buyer inspections, check of buyer inspections. Tell me what else have I missed? Test of buildings.
Photo shoots,
yeah. Okay, so what I want you to do is block those things we know we're going to have to do into your week. Then what I want you to do is there's other things that come. There's training, there's fitness and health, family time, all that type of thing. You call the big rocks. Everyone ever heard that saying? You put the big rocks in the beaker, and then after they say you use the beaker full, and a lot of people go, yes. Then the guy pulled out the sand, pours down the sand, says, no, it's not full. There's all the area. Then they says it's full. They said, no, that's not full. The other guy pulled out water. The other says, not full. Still not full, right?
Give me the second cup.
Give me the second cup. So we've got to look at this. So no idea week is a killer. If you haven't got an idea week, and I don't know who you are, I'll be your mentor. Send it to me. Do one, but send it to someone so you actually force yourself to do it. I can give you a template of an idea week right now. Part of it, most of your day is going to be prospecting. The other part of your day is going to be running buyers through or listing presentations, right? This is the easiest business in the world to not overcomplicate. Let me tell you how hard it is. Write this down. Find a buyer, find someone who wants to sell, and take a commission. Have I missed anything?
No.
But I'm not being smart. If I missed anything, I might sound like you, but find a buyer, find a seller, take a commission. Forget everything else. Forget how your photo looks. Forget that the market's doing this. Forget the market's doing that. I talk about two marketplaces, right? So there's two marketplaces. You know what they are? There's one between your ears, right? And there's one out there. So one out there is who's in liberal. What's happening in the war in China and America? What's happening between the interest rates, right? That one, have a guess what? Are we ever going to control it? Right. What about this one? Can we control it?
Yes.
Work on this marketplace and forget all the other marketplaces. All you have to do, $1 million ride is a groovy. I bet you all you're doing all that, I can guarantee I'm not with you. You're running buyers and doing listing presentations, correct? And I bet you guys have worked out how to get rid of everything that's not dollar productive in your life. I pulled a guy out the other day, I was telling Paul, he was underneath on the floor fixing a photocopier. I said, get here, come and go for a copy. What are you doing? You're writing $1.5 million and you spend an hour on it on fixing a photocopier. Do you know what your hourly rates were? Do you guys know what you need to know these things? Write these down. Do you know what your hourly rate is? If you know what your hourly rate is,
you'll be very careful how you use your hours.
Xerox should be doing the copier.
Yeah, outsource it. Outsource. Get a 50k resource and pay them directly to go and do all the non-dollar. I'm gonna be really brutal, guys, with you. This is how we get people to write a million and more and 570, 2 million, 3 million. And we've got a guy, Tommy and I work very closely, who wants to go from 6 million to 10 million. Have a guess. The thinking that got him from 1 million to 2 million, then got him from 3 million to four, then from four to six, has all been different thinking. You can't. What's got you here is not going to get you there. You with me on that? So right, no ideal week, no ideal month, no idea. You need to have a year, your whole year needs to be planned. As boring as that sounds, routine sets you free. As boring as that sounds. I can tell you when I'm going on holidays in the next 12 months, I can tell you what, Brack, I have to, because I can't just leave and not know when Tom's away, what Paul's doing, what I'm doing, what my team are doing. Just going to say I'm going on holidays for him. I know, and I know where he's going. Right now, we knew that in January, right? We know what we're doing in January. The whole team has to sit down and tell everyone what we're doing. We just don't wake up by accident. And it happens. It happens. So, ideal year. What's your training like? What's your holidays like? What's your family time like? What's your health like? What's your gym exercise? What are you doing? What are you doing every week? Where's your time going? And the more you make your time, the more boring it is in your week, the more successful you'll be. Does every who of the million dollar eyes are going to be there? If it's just repetitive, past clients, biggest blind spot in this business, past clients. You've got all these agents running out there going, oh, I did all these letterbox and didn't get a phone call. Oh, really? Okay. Well, see, if you know those letterboxes are empty, half of them are being emptied by cleaners or building maintenance people, nannies that have got these that are looking after people. So half of the people don't even, they've got a Sulo bin. Whose house does this? My house is like this. I've got the mail, the Sulo bin, and then my front door. So I just stand over. Who does this? I just stand over. Don't even look at the stuff. And that's your hard-earned money going there. Take that money, get your last 20 clients who sold a house for, bring them to Harvey's Cafe or Spoon or somewhere around here. I don't know if you guys know them, wherever right here from, and spend an afternoon with them to say thank you and give them a candle and give them a nice personal price or something and just say thank you. That will generate more business in your rest of your real estate. I did that for 20 years every year. I had a big car wash right in the eastern suburbs. A friend owns the most successful car wash. And I just got all my clients to come down there on a Tuesday afternoon once a year and get all their cars washed and I'd give them a whole lot of gifts. But he just blocked the car wash out for me for the afternoon. Everyone's got a car, everyone wants to wash it, no one wants to spend $50. I just do that for them. That was my gift, so thank you. And I would fill it up. They'd say, oh, can I bring them? They'd all be talking to me. Have my team down there with them. We'd be having an absolute ball of a time. And I'd give them a gift. And out of there, I'd pick up three or four listings. I don't understand. We're carrying, let's just think of Santa Claus. He's got the bag over his shoulder with all the past clients and he's looking for new ones and the bag is sitting here and not even talking. They'd say, think like that. That's real estate. Horrendous. Empty the bag of past clients to say thank you.
We like to say not even past clients, they're just clients.
Yes. They're not past clients.
Oh, they pass.
Yes.
They didn't pass away.
They didn't pass away.
They're still alive.
No plan property. No plan ties in with the first one. What's your plan? Okay. How much do you want to write? And I'll give you a video on this. This is a major problem in real estate. Biggest one in real estate is ego. What are we doing? I mean, understand. I would think like, Charlie Teo. Does everyone know who Charlie Teo is, the brain surgeon? Right. He should be running around going, here I am, trying to save some eight-year-old with his life for that. Wouldn't even know who he is.
Yeah.
Right? Real estate agents are doing this on social media, and look at me and the flashy cars. And what are you doing to save the eight-year-old's life? We sold the house. Hello? And we're working in a mum's and dad's business. Do we agree that?
Yeah.
Mums and dads hate egos. Have a guess for that for a story. Why the ego in real estate? You're in a mum's and dad's business. You listen, if you could put a GoPro on some of these people coming to some of to open where the agents have got big egos and listen to what they say when they leave, thank you, I was going to say that. Distractions are huge. Huge. What's happening in the market? Why? Something didn't sell on it. Forget about it. Find a buyer, find a seller, take a commission. Who can do that from today? Just forget about everything else. Forget about what Ray White's doing, Raymond Horne, or Clay. Not interested. You can't control it. What you're not doing is a problem.
Right. And we're going to talk about that in a minute.
Lack of training. It's not up to Paul to do the training.
Right.
There's Tom Panos. There's our stuff on YouTube. There's, I'll keep going. There's Seth Godin, someone mentioned before. Ryan, where are you? There's 100 million things you can get on YouTube for free. Mm-hmm. And you can go to every seminar. I'm not saying go to every seminar. Pick the best ones. You agree?
Yeah.
Just pick the best ones.
Yeah.
Training, coaching, mentoring. You've got to back yourself on this. You have to, and then when you go and do it, don't just sit there like a statue in the crowd. Write down notes and implement. The success of any ideas in the implementation, do we agree on that?
Okay.
And here's Mr. Implementer over here on the wall. I'm showing you virtual tours and sitting in shop. I can't understand that stuff. That's how far Paul's head is into the tech space. But it's amazing what Paul's doing. This is a big one and probably a great one. The ladies probably understand this. And the guys, okay, we talked about some. Got a handbag? Ladies must have a handbag. When was the last time you tipped everything out and had a look what you got in there? Right? It's amazing what you'll find. I've got a wife and an 18-year-old daughter. Trust me. I tell them, and that's a metaphor, right? Repack your bags is a metaphor. Guys that have got your gym bags and stuff tucked in the back of your boot, open it up, you'll find something there you didn't know you had, right? You'll find stuff in your handbag, ladies, you forgot you lost. So what I'm saying, that's a mental repack your bags. Every 12 months, empty your bag out and start again. What's not working, what did work, pack it up again and start again. You're carrying too much baggage, right? You don't need. No financial plan, huge one. When you make all this $1 million, where's it going? Spend the money, get a proper financial planner, sit down. You know you're going to have a silent partner in this business called the ATO, right? Okay? You know the ATO? Everybody know the ATO? They're a silent partner sitting there. So when you get $1,000 in, because guess what? You haven't got $1,000. Don't spend $1,000. Take half of it away, put it in a rainy day tax account, and live off the $500, right? With me? And that's how it is. Sorry to tell you. Not the desired thing we like, but they're out. So I think you don't have a financial plan, you're going to be in trouble. Get a financial planner to do a budget. No rainy day accounts, sort of that. No, a big one, huge one, right? Imagine if I was standing up here now doing this. My God.
We'd be nodding off.
Yeah. Right, I'm not creating it, it's just the way I am, right? Because I know if I'm going to walk into someone's house, and that's where I've been praying, I'm going to get the list in because I've got the best energy.
Yeah.
People buy your energy. They don't care. I could forget what I look like, forget anything. They're buying your energy. I can go in a room of people I don't know and have five people around in 15 minutes. No, not even know them, because I'll ask questions, I'll talk, I'll embrace myself. This business, you've got to self-promote yourself. Do you agree?
I did that exactly recently with a property that I bought.
Wonderful.
Three agents, basically, all over the shop, but they were clawed.
Yeah.
But the guy that walked in and he was considered conversation, used his emotional intelligence, mirrored my conversation.
Brilliant.
And the others were either directors or they were bouncers all over the shop. And I went, no, he's on the ball.
How good that. So who believes that energy is important?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Do you check your energy when you walk in? Like, what about your open house? You're doing open houses, oh, come on in, here's a brochure, what's your name?
It's the same thing as when you make a call to each other, Mark. If you make a call, you're in a bad mood, people are going to
deal with
it.
Absolutely.
You're in a mood, knock it out.
So that's true. That's really a good point you mentioned, because that's where they can't see you. Wait till they can see you and they pick up the man.
We're in the first answer.
But let me tell you, here's another thing. So let's shift the thinking. I'm going to now shoot myself in the foot for what I just said. All the same, who's actually bought something from a bad salesperson? Right? Who's ever done that? Walked into a shop? Yeah, okay. The most of the hands go. So here's another theory. If you can't be the best at what you do, what did you buy them? Buy that thing because the person was there?
No.
And you wanted the product? No?
No. I wanted the product.
You wanted the product. Yeah. So you bought it irrespective of the bad. So here's another theory. If you can't be good, be there. Just turn up, right? Okay. Don't worry about having all the skills, just turn up, because you just proved that we bought something on someone that was crap. Right? So here's another theory, you can't be good with it. So turn up, right, get up when it's raining, it's cold, just get up. Kick yourself in the bum and have a plan. If you have a plan, you'll get up, right? I skip to work every day, right? I don't have to, I don't have to kick the sheets off to get out. I'm up. I've got a plan. I know exactly what I'm doing. Paul sat down with me nearly two years ago now. Thomas and I were sitting down with, we're going to 600 agents in 5 years. That's the plan. I'll just keep going till I get there. And then when we're getting close to six, when we're at 450 or five, we'll say, how do we go to 1,000? Because the thinking has got us to where we are. I'm not going to be the thinking that's going to get us to 1,000. We're going to have to rethink it all. What's the next strategy, et cetera, et cetera. So this is, we're doing is no different than what you're doing, right? And poor focus. Talk about the photocopier, talk about, you know, oh, look, oh, the call back to the big cold, I got home early. You know what I said? Poor focus. Stick to the game. If it's, I think it's a really good thing. One of our agents, not one of the top agents, one of the agents is on, I call them rising stars, right? What he does, he's got a table and he's got 50 on a page. And he does not leave his phone and doesn't X until he's made 50 calls out. He just keeps Xing and made 50 calls. Oh, I don't care what it is, it's just 50 calls. So imagine having that. It's something you can do. Go home, build a, Paul's probably got the template. I know Paul will just lick his fingers if over the screen for 2 minutes. I know how he does this stuff. There's a table, right? It's got 50 little boxes in it, and you just put a square every time you make a call to get to 50. And you just do that every day, past clients, future clients, pipelines, buyers, whatever. As soon as you get 50, you might do 100. Could be 100 for the million-dollar riders, get more calls to make. You do that every single day. I promise you something will happen. But if you do that, if you measure it, it gets done. If you don't, if you just randomly go and make some calls, and you end up with 30, that's 50 is the number you're going to break through. And how many times have I said to him, and when he gets gold, he puts a red circle around the cross, right? He said, you know, I just did it because the way he did that was he realised it was that 50th call or that 30th call when he was going to give up that actually yielded something, right? Who's proven that? Yeah? Who has a system like that? Okay, good. So we've got some room to move. Poor communication is the biggest. If you do a survey around the real estate industry, that's why most agents are hated in real estate. Now, we've got a bad name because people think we're dodgy, right? We're not. Most 99% of agents, I know most of them, they're not dodgy, they're not liars, they're good people. They just have poor communication. To over-communicate with your clients, over-communicate with the buyers, over-communicate with each other. See, okay, here's the thing. Forget Paul's even in the room. How many of you guys have got together without Paul, sat down and built a little get together every week? Okay, two. Okay, so how many in the group in total? So don't wait for Paul or Sydney or no.
We work together.
Okay, so three. Yep. Good. So what about the other? So we've got 15 in the room. So who else? No one else thinks because the energy in group getting together. And I'm just thinking. I'll tell you what. When I started Madras with John, there were seven of us, right? And we didn't have the budgets to do training, and we weren't doing it. So what I decided to do was why don't step, we've all got the same challenges, right? We've around that. Why don't we all just get a coffee on a Friday morning, and we actually set the chairs up in a circle, and we just went around the room and said, what's working, what's not working, to each other. And someone in that circle had the answer, right? And one of my other favourite sayings, and I can tell you, every time Thomas or I sit down with any agent, there's always got challenges. And I always say to every single agent, I'll tell you what, let's get 10 agents in a circle. Everyone throws their problems in the circle. You'll quickly pull yours back out and you see everyone else's. Right? And I can prove that. You throw your issues in the middle, oh, this is it. You're someone else, you'll quickly take your problems back and you see everyone else's. So that's 90% of the problem. People think, oh, it's me, I got this, I can't fix it. The market's doing that, the brand does this. Brands don't tell home people do. They follow you guys. What are you doing with your energy? Lack of transparency, big one, huge. If it's not, just don't tell a lie. It's as simple as that. Lose the business. There's a YouTube video of me and Tom Panos, and Tom Panos interviewing me, and I'm talking about a pest and building inspection guy wanted me to lie that they had termites in the house, and they put this mat over the corner and said, look, we haven't got money to spend it. Go and find that and watch it, and that will show you about transparency. But that's all pretty simple, yeah? Probably heard it all before somewhere.
Yes, simple.
Okay, simple. So, but that's your million-dollar business plan. It's there. There it is.
Okay, because a lot when I asked for a lot of hands, there weren't many that went up on these. There's the $1 million business. But that's what the $1 million riders do. They've got a plan. They've got an idea week. They've got a business plan. They repack their bags. They train. They don't have. They never. The top riders get headsets. Doesn't matter where they. Even if they're at home working, they've got a headset on and they're just cranking it out. They don't distract it. You can't talk to our top riders when they're in, if they're in an office. You can't talk when they're too. The ones that are doing half the sale a month are on the water cooler talking about the football results and talking about what the work's called today, isn't it? And did you see that, you know, what Trump said and all that? I love my colleagues, but hey, you know what? I'm not selling them a house. So have a guess what? I'll spend time with them on Friday around that circle and we'll talk about what's working on it and we'll build a network. How much referrals in this room that's not getting pushed to each other? Have you thought of
probably about huge amount.
Huge.
Yeah.
What about I just become an agent, I'll take all your referrals and I'll go and do them and send you 10%. What about that? Or you guys get together as a group and say, oh, you're working that area, I'm working this area, you're doing this, you know, let's get together. You should be getting together as a group with the relevant agents that potentially, like, you know what I mean? There's an owner moving from here to buying here. And then these people are selling and going back to here. And you guys are probably those people in the room who are not connecting enough. Because imagine if you could say, look, I've got my great agent, Mary. She's up in that market. Hang on a sec. Hey, Mary, I'm just down at Smith Street. I've got Paul Mandoni here looking to move up to your market. Clink. You'll control the market in 12 months. Because you just control the inquiry.
You just say transfers.
You just control the inquiry.
You guys are doing that at the moment with WhatsApp group as well.
What about this? What about putting this in for the whole group? What about you do your open on a Saturday? What about you try this? Everyone does their opens on a Saturday, and you email the whole group to tell everyone what happened on Saturday.
Yeah.
What would everyone think of that?
Right.
So if you're out at, give me a suburb you're working in, ma'am. Cooper. So you're out there. What about yourself? No?
I'm just starting.
That's all right. Next one. What about yourself? What suburbs? Which one?
Ascot.
Okay, Ascot, Coobra. So imagine if you've been going, oh, look, my colleague was out at Ascot and he had 13 through his open and all that. So you're knowing what everyone else is doing. How good would that be when you knew? So you're sitting there going, I had one through my open. You'd feel better if then you knew 30 others had one through their open too. Because what that will do to you, if you've got one and you don't get 15, you need an extra half. Do you remember what an SBR is? What was it?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going.
A substantial price reduction. That's what you're doing. It's a slash and burn. You get one through and everyone else gets 13 through. Who can do that? Can we set that up? Here he is. He's just done it. The email's going out tomorrow. Imagine if we sent it. I don't know. I could be causing carnage here by saying it. But what could we lose by doing it?
Nothing.
Right. Great. And I'm talking to, don't give war on these guys, please. I've been an agent myself. Just take it. Hey guys, did open at Cooperoo, 13 through, two contracts, exchanging tomorrow, whatever, offer on contract. That's all. Not did an open, met the dog, got introduced to the cat, there's a bird came through, a car accident the street, the market was here, like, you know, there was a fake down there. No. Okay. Let's have some, yeah, okay. All right. So let's
next one.
Yeah, thanks, bud. So a couple of quick things to watch your video. Yeah. All right. No.
I watched this video.
Who's got opens tomorrow? Okay, great. Beautiful. So we could start that. Actually, I've got some slides.
Do you want to go to slides?
Yeah, just some of the other. I'll let it go up. Did anyone think Dr. Eric Thomas? This guy is amazing. Okay. Anyone seen this before? I thought it was great. I played this at our Kickstart spring conference. Fear has two meanings. Forget everything and run. Or face everything and rise. The choice is yours. Right? Yeah, isn't that great? Isn't that heavy? Okay, next one, thanks. These are just quick little things. All the problems are stuck between mind and matter. If you don't mind, it doesn't matter, right? If you don't mind, who cares what's happening? We'll never control who's in government. We're never going to control what the weather's doing tomorrow. We're never going to control that Trump wants to have a fight with China. We're never going to control if there's a car accident in the street. We're never going to control whether the Reserve Bank decides to put the effort. And it's going to happen for the rest of your real estate career. So get over it, forget about it, move on. What you can control, how many X are you putting on the page, what's your energy like, how many opens you're doing, how you treat your colleagues, how you respect your family, how you look after your kids, how do you look after your wife, how do you look after your husband, because that's all part of business to me. I don't want to be a great real estate agent and a shit husband, right? I don't want to be really good at what I do and be a shit father. Sorry, excuse the swear. I don't want to be really good at what I do and a bad colleague to my colleagues. That's not how I want to operate. I want to be great everywhere, right? And I'm going to keep, that's what I do, it's my life, right? I don't think you should have to vary it. I don't want to lie to, I want to lie to my vendors and be honest to my kids. Well, tell me how that works, right? It doesn't work, right? Okay, this is a big one of mine. Thomas and I use this all the time. How many people have you seen that have just got the will but they don't have the skill of smashing it? Anyone seen that?
Yeah.
And if you ask yourself, you go, so we can't judge, Thomas and I and Paul, we can't judge. We don't care. Me personally, I don't care. I've got race, religion, I don't interest it. If they got the energy and they're a good person and they got the will, we'll teach them the skill. The will is the key. The skill can be taught. It's not that hard. There's some of the most skillful people in the world that don't have the will. How many times have you seen it? They can tell you every script and dialogue for a script, but you can't pick up the phone, you got the will, you're weak. Right? You can't talk about skill or will. It's the will, not the skill. Don't worry about having it. We get agents, Tommy gets them, I'm going into a listening presentation, what script and dialogue? Just go in there, have high energy, embrace the people. Tommy's going to whip out the magic dust and go, there it is.
Who's heard of analysis paralysis? When you analyse everything so much that you get paralysed, well, you don't actually do anything.
How many
times have you an experienced agent, you're in the market, and you're up against another experienced agent, and then you both lose it, and then absolute nobody picks up the listing, and you go,
that's a good feeling.
What the hell? Like, no bonus working crap or something? Like, is that crazy?
But that was really
nice to see it. And it's a little bit again.
100%.
All the time.
100%. And Thomas will tell you, he gets a lot of agents calling about nothing, right? And we were talking about this morning, can you remember? I said, when an agent calls me about something, I said, look, I'm dead. You can't call me now, but call me back in 5 minutes and tell me what you would have done if I was dead. Quit my phone call. 9% of the time, you guys have got the answer or they've got the answer, but it's just tweaking that. So it's about not, sometimes about just backing yourself too, you know? Okay. All right. What about they're going to run through them quick? 10 successful innovations people thought wouldn't work. So here's where we are in the market right now. Guys, we're being disrupted everywhere. Uber won't work, said the taxi industry. Online stores won't work, said the bricks and mortars, right? Netflix won't work, said cable TV and cinemas. Internet won't work, said the newspapers. Mm-hmm. Chatbots won't work, said the call center agents. Airbnb won't work, said the hotels. Paul, you become a commoner. So think about that. One of the biggest brands when I was growing up was Kodak.
Oh,
redundant, right? I had a Nokia mobile phone. Who had a Nokia mobile phone? Who had a BlackBerry? Right? Now, two brands control the phone market. Apple and Samsung. They have something like insane market share. Here's the key though. Apple only has one real phone. Nokia had 90 models.
Yep.
Right? So think of all that. Just Apple's got their head in the zone of keep it simple. Right? Build something really good with not a lot of choice. And that's the, see, Apple have got that theory of find a buyer, find a seller, take a fee. Nokia have got all the other agents going, I've got to be doing this before I get it. I've got to lose 10 kilos before I go to this. I've got to cut my hair this way. I've got to do this. I've got to talk. I've got to get this script dialed. While they're doing that, someone else is listening. And I use this analogy. Paul said to me, say, there's a lot of agents around. They're sitting there counting the smarties and this, that, and the other, where someone's unbolting their safe out the back. Right? stop looking at the minutia and look at the big picture. It's a really big thing, isn't it? All right, I think we're good. Oh, this is a great one. It's my favourite. I saw this when I first started and realised I pinched this off the REI in New South Wales. The young man who waited for the real estate price to come down. Right, so there's your answer. So, you know, when you get these vendors, use that slide. Just say, look, Mr. John, I'm going to show you something funny here. Have a look at this, right? Because that's from the REI New South Wales. You can say, you know, that's where it came from. Because that's actually why we're going to wait for the prices to come down. And you know what? You never ever know when the prices have come down, because when they're level, you only know because they're going up again.
Right? Crazy.
And right? When we're not going to buy at the peak, by the time you're not buying at the peak, right, you're not, we're going to sell at the peak, we're going to wait for a peak. You only know it's peak when it's coming down again. So who can pick that? We'd all be retired if we knew that. So if you have that dialogue ready, and that's not a script, that's just true authenticity, right? And there's, it's all right, we're just going to finish off, okay, this is a good one. Don't be upset by the result you didn't get for the work you didn't do. All right, that's the plan, okay, so good. Now, I've got this next video. It's not deep. I'm not a deep, so one of those guys. But that's just good. These are just little good ones. I'll run through them too. Smart person knows what to say. A wise person knows whether to say it or not. I'm going to send these to Paul. Because big thing in real estate, you just can't overtalk. It's 80% them, 20% you. It's questions, 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 questions. Right? Your ICANN is more important than your IQ. Okay, we talked about that before, skill and will. Even if you're on the right track, you'll get run over if you sit there. There's some backers, right? So good, we're going to go to this video. So Eric Thomas, I saw this a while ago. I could have played a few things today here, but this one I always get people in awe of this because... yeah, so this is here, I'm going to cut off. Let you do the talking.
What's next? It was swimming in.
Everybody else, but we've got to look deep inside, and we're controlling. Like I said to Paul and Sydney this morning, like at the end of the day, you are your CEO. You're the CEO of your own business. Do we agree with that?
Yes.
You can put CEO on your own time. You're the CEO of your own business. But what I'm going to ask yourself when you go home or back wherever you're going this afternoon, to think about this: if you were a company and you were running it, would you hire yourself? Because you're actually the CEO. Would you hire yourself to run your company? Because that's what you've actually done. And if it's maybe, maybe not, what have you got to do to actually rehire yourself? Right? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So you're the CEO of your business. You're what you are when you go out. So you've got to, and would you hire yourself? Because that's what you've done. If you go on, if you're maybe, if I did this, I probably would hire whatever it is that you've come up with in your own personal time. That's what you need to probably put yourself to the fire of, as he said. Okay, so I thought, look, today, don't want to overload things. I know a busy day tomorrow in the field. You've probably got things to do this afternoon. What I thought we'd do, just wrapping up, is just maybe get a sense of around the room as we took something away from today. Would you like to share it? There's no right or wrong. You don't have to answer. You don't have to do anything. But if you took something away, what will you implement would be good. Tommy and I might just go through that together. What, anyone like to start? What, who took something away from this morning?
Well, I love the virtual office. I think that's great. I think it's great for international clients, etc.
Absolutely.
I know you've got to have face-to-face value, which obviously everybody does.
Yeah.
But, yeah, the international, it's really good for that sort of thing.
That's awesome. Okay. Yeah. Anyone else?
Some of the advantages of success were...
Thank you. Yep, good. Okay. Anything particular that you've sort of jumped out at you?
Probably the more, the ideal week bigger.
Yeah, okay. It's a big one, that no idea week, because it's like we're saying, if we're going to Fortitude Valley from here and I don't know where I'm going, I've got to have a GPS to get me there. If I don't, and that's the idea week. If you want to go from 500 to a million, that's your, what's your GPS to get you there? And what's going to tell you left, right, left, right, left, right on the way? Because if you don't, if you go like that, you're not going to get there, right? Anything else?
Energy.
Energy. It's a big one, isn't it?
Transfer.
Transfer of energy. If you just shifted your energy 10%, I'm not saying all of a sudden go out and start skipping and throwing flowers around people's lounge rooms at open houses. I'm not saying put ACDC on when they went out to an open home either. Right? I'm not saying that. Right? I'm just saying look people in the eye. Hi, I'm Matt LaHood. Welcome. Are you buying or selling today? Come for it. You're just asking that question. If you ask that question, are you buying or selling today? You're looking.
That's a perfect example. Friday afternoon, I was in Corporate Pharma, driving, you know, one-year-old facade, pulled up, open house, went in Friday afternoon, looked, oh, hello, how are you, welcome, you know, saw me pull up, went back Saturday morning at 9 o'clock for the second inspection, pulled up in a red three-year-old Fiat, pair of shorts, sand shoes. She didn't recognise me.
Okay.
That'd be the usual, yeah.
And 10 minutes later in conversation, I'm with me.
Yeah.
Yeah. 12 hours ago.
Now I'm
alive. Do you think I bought that house through heaven? No.
Isn't that hilarious?
Yeah.
Sorry, thank you for sharing. Okay, so dangerous, right?
The thing with energy, though, is not thinking that you've got to be on all the time. Like, it's energy management just as important as time management. And it's a misconception that like, you're going to have to be on all the time. And it is hard. Like, well, sometimes life is ready there to kick in the face. Every single day, you've got to make sure that you turn yourself on, just like you turn a TV on, but you also turn it off sometimes and you get into the right frame of mind. The biggest thing Matt and I see is that the biggest problem with most people not achieving what they want to achieve is themselves. Like 99.9% of the time, it's themselves. So you are your biggest problem, but the other thing is you're also the solution to actually start getting things happening. So,
yeah.
Big things to look at.
The problem and the solution. How powerful that too.
Oh, yeah.
It's all in the one-stop shop. Mm. Anyone else like to share anything? Yeah. What about yourself? You've soaked it all in.
Absolutely.
Anything jump out of your bed?
A lot.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah, definitely.
That's good.
Yeah.
I think I need
to
get an there, which is not true,
don't
say.
Yeah, that's it. You can't buy integrity. And the problem is, in this industry, you've got one name on, meaning your damage is done.
I went to a open house yesterday, Bald Hills.
Yeah.
And an old shack.
Yeah.
I walked through, and there's this gap at the where they've done an extension of a good 5 inches.
Yeah.
And going, oh, since the diamond. Yeah, there's some structural work to be done at this property. And like, tell me before I come in.
Oh, yeah. See, that's just not right, is it?
Yeah.
So imagine if that agent said, oh, Caroline, I've got to point out a few things before you kick off inspection.
You're nuts.
There's some sizes here. We've had a builder through the quote's 5,000. So if you're interested in your trust, just go paying what that is. Right? And here's the quote from the builder. Give them a call.
Have the quote with
you. Yeah. How good is that? Thanks for sharing that. Because that's that thing about that depth of building that you'll see that the owner tried to get to hide the termite dam across the town. Any one last thing before we close?
Yeah, just putting North Post into it.
Putting North Post?
Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Paul, anything you want to wrap up with tonight?
No, I think energy.
Yeah,
energy. I love Matt's energy, Matt Thomas. Yeah, these guys are energy. I think that really comes through. You know, I think the skills keep taught.
Yeah,
100%. 100%. But I think, you know, with the energy level being there, right, you're going to be winning for a step on.
Yeah,
100%.
No, that's it.
I love that.
What do you do when the battery's getting low, boys?
Good question. So when I'm off, I'm off.
Yeah.
It's a big thing. Okay, so you've got, you know, I've got an 18-year-old and a 20-year-old.
Yeah.
So they, for the sort of first part of their lives, they're about 13, it was always mum, dad. Now it's like me. I'm on because they're working. And so I'm almost like, thanks, Felo. You can deal with it now. I still don't deal with the boyfriend-girlfriend management.
That's hard.
But, no, the things like where they're going to their fish. So when I'm on with them. That keeps you grounded from my point of view. I've got a good circle of friends that aren't in real estate, right, that keep me in other industries. And I'm in, well, I've got a head of security guy that's one of my kindergarten. He's got a huge security. He looks after the Camilla stores across Australia. And he's got stories, and he rings me for what am I to help you grow and what are you doing. I've got another couple of famous horse trainer and people that are clients of mine that become friends. And they just take me out of the zone sort of thing. So then you do your normal things. Like I walk, try and walk every single morning, even if it's like 15 minutes, half an hour, go around the block, whatever, just to get head going.
Oxygen.
Always at night try and do some sort of educational 15, 20 minute read of something, whether it's a YouTube, so I think that's me. Tommy's got things different.
Well, the big thing for me, I'll give you an idea. Yesterday, my first meeting was 7:30. I called six options last night in a town called Wollongong, which is 2 hours south of Sydney. I got home from there after calling those six options at 10:30. I was up this morning at 5 a.m. to be here.
Yeah.
The reality is you're going to be tired regardless. It's what you consume. So in the car this morning, we're at the airport. I listened to a Robin Sharma podcast, which gave me good information. Once I got to the airport, the way to the boarding gate, I knew he'd be up. So he's up at 5 a.m. every single morning. So I rang Matt, 6:30.
Yeah.
So I rang Matt, I'm on the way to the boarding gate. This is my day yesterday. How was your day yesterday? Because I get the energy from that. So the minute you try and think everything's perfect, nothing's ever perfect.
No.
You've got to understand that sometimes what we do in real estate is organized chaos. And it's okay to be that way. But a lot of what's you consuming. So, you know, I've been listening to commercial radio for I don't know how long. I just don't even know who's on the radio these days, right? So it's always podcasts, always YouTube videos, always talking to people that I know I can get good energy back. And then the people that we call them energy sucking vampires, the people that are just sending you bad vibes, they are out of my life. Right? So that's the big thing.
And I've got to say that I can speak to Thomas. We've been very close working colleagues. Thomas we both get the industry right. This industry's got to be sharp. I choose not to drink because it doesn't work for me. Right? Thomas chooses, he can only sparingly drink. He's doing, how many options are you doing on a Saturday every Saturday?
10 or 12.
And partying and all that sort of stuff. We're not like sitting in a corner like not going out or doing anything. We're at a Redlands Walsall. 2 a.m. last Saturday for one of our colleagues, a 650 Thomas did the auction. He did 9 on Saturday auctions and went and did 20 charity items on the Saturday night. And then I was out with my, we were all at that time for our company. So we're out there, but we're very strict on our time that we use because we have to be on our A game for our team, right? So you've got to manage your time. I think Thomas said that well.
Yeah.
Paul, what you do, you're up, you're into the gym, you do a bit of energy things too.
Yeah, it's almost repetitive. You know, up at 6, and I've got the iPad on the running machine, and I've gone through the news, I've gone through my emails, and we've gone through it. And by the time the hour's up, I'm ready to go. Matt's already sent me 20 emails.
I've been told plenty of times that instant coffee's not fast enough for me that I should drink 3 decaf. That's what all my friends tell me. But it's just it is what it is. I can't change what's in my molecular construction.
But it's about energy and I guess to take it down a level. It's about being focused at in whatever you're doing, being there.
Yeah.
Right? You can't be somewhere else, whether it's for work, whether it's with your family, whether it's with kids.
Yeah.
I coach my son's hockey team, and they're great, but yeah, there's the occasional one that's, you know, now using the stick as an ice order.
Yeah.
But I think it's just a lesson, you know, it's fun and we'll don't go overboard. But to get people to just to realise, you know, when you're in class or at school, you're going to be there, you're going to be working at the moment, whether you're playing here, whether you're working, it's a good lesson.
Just in closing, too, off ball set, I think this is one of our biggest problems in life, personally. Causing huge dramas amongst kids. It's causing people to be tied to it, right? There's something about us up on it's unbelievable, but it's also massively destructive. Social media, if you don't manage that, if anyone's got kids, you'll know what I mean, about photos and stuff loading and comments to do with it at a party, didn't get invited to a party. We never had all that problems, right? Oh. My dad's 80, right, and he's got the best life of everything, and he doesn't have any of this in your office, right? He won't even answer it when he goes, like, who's ringing me? He usually sees, like, four of his main numbers and doesn't answer it, right? But and that's just a different sort of. It's good. We can learn a lot from our elders as well. Like, because my kids come over and he says, "Well, you can't you put that thing down for 5 minutes?" And he I learn off him that he's got the best life. He's not worried about what's on LinkedIn or who did something on Instagram. That's just where he's at. His life, fine. But there's a lot to be taken. I try to take a balance on that. You know, like taking it and. I see people in bed doing it, sending photos. It just depends where you're at, right? But think, just remember it too. Because people don't, until you say, oh, yeah, I'm on my phone a lot. And the worst thing is it opens, right? Don't take it into a listing presentation. Yeah. The minute you're not with them, Paul just said it, you're not there. I never take this into a listing presentation. And if I take it to an open, it's on silent and it's in the front in the folder. And then when there's nobody in the house, I go and check it, so things like that. I've seen some of the, come on through to your house.
Where's the social manners?
Where's the social manners gone? And it seems to be accepted. Kids to be, like, you know, I see families that we have a rule, like, if I don't get to see the kids, the girlfriend's boyfriend scenario now, so anytime they've got an ink with me, right, so I'll call my wife. Wife and I, we don't have our phones if we go out for a coffee and they're just leaving the car.
Yeah.
Right, especially if it's weekend. If I'm working, it's different stories if I catch up with them in between stuff. But the reality is that I've seen how many families that have got for dinner
on their phone.
They're not on their phone. Seriously, guys, I mean, really, we can stop that because real estate, you're tied to it, right?
Yeah.
You get that. But you've got to have downtime, right? So I think it's just, I'm pointing it out because people probably haven't pointed it out to you before. Mm. I look at these things where they can cause dramas in our lives. At some point, I just go kick it to the curb, right? And have a guess what? The world will still turn on its axis if you're not on it. We're going to wrap up. So, yeah.
Just quickly explain, maybe we should touch on the culture. It's very simple. And I think Matt hit one of the points. There is no ego. You know, we're accessible to everyone. We don't see ourselves as bosses or CEOs. Yeah, you've got that title, but we're all colleagues. We don't think we've got the best ideas of the world. Me and Matt always, you know, the front of all knowledge doesn't reside in my office. You know, I want everyone to contribute to the benefit of the company.
Okay.
And the team is important. In Perth, we have the no DH rule.
Mm-hmm.
When someone comes, we put it out to our team and the reps around them. If they say no, that person's got this done, this, it's a no. I don't care how much the Britain, right? So we won't allow anyone that won't fit into our culture, into our team, no matter what value or passion they could bring into the organisation. So it is very much about the team. We're all accessible.
Yeah.
You know, if someone goes, oh, sorry to call you, I know you know, I don't apologise. And if I can't help you, I'll check it straight away.
Yeah.
That's not my area. I could probably get better information from Stuart, our sales in WA or our licensee. So it's a very flat structure. It is a team, you know, team family, we change it. We come together for our people. Some, you know, it's one of our people, one of our agents, unfortunately, their child passed away, went through some horrific, luck, you know, marriage breakups, little, just all in a row. Just awful. And, you know, one of the proudest moments for me is our group raised 20 grand in about 48 hours and raised all the funeral expenses. You know, it was a total disaster. Probably the best highlight of my career.
That's amazing. Wow.
So I think it's important that you would talk about this, both about the organisation being a flat structure, everyone looking out for everyone. So, same in Perth, we've all got teams that work together, friendships have been developed, they all rely on bounce ideas, and that's just fantastic, you know, and that's something that we're very proud of.
And that connected email we're talking about is bring everyone, because it creates conversation. Oh, such a 43, I'm going to give them a call. Well, you wouldn't normally, because you know what's happening, right? And it builds trust, frequency builds trust because you guys are communicating more. But today was really about, Paul and I had a conversation, and Paul, and it was about, like, you guys have got some really exciting things. We've got a brand. We're coming to Brisbane. We're going to go hard. It's about how can we sort of work together. So I know Paul's had some conversations about what we're going to offer when we come, et cetera, effectively. Similar model, et cetera. We'll just do a little bit more of this sort of stuff. There'll be obviously some different agents that will potentially follow Thomas and I. So the branding will be a different. We're going to make a hell of a lot of noise when we arrive here. But that's just what we do. It's effectively we're about promoting hard the brand and the agents effectively. It's that the agents promote the brand. Yeah, that. So we're constantly finding that it's the properties they list get. We generate a lot of PR off the back of properties. Well, so that's what people want to read. And they want to read. They're unfortunately not going to read about the agents. They want to read about the properties, and that's what the paper want to put out there and the web portals about, because that drives, like, obviously the traffic to them, right? Stories go. So effectively that's where we're at. So Paul, really in closing.
Thank you guys for coming all the way from Perth and that's crazy. Just for one day.
Yeah,
like 25 just for us. And I've got to say, man, we had a conversation, man, and I sat down. I thought, man, this guy is an amazing guy. I was a mutual contact that brought us together. I've got to say, Matt didn't mention this, but you look after probably the highest riders in the country, right? Pretty much.
Yeah, we have done over the
last $7 million. Yeah. You know, there's got to be a method, there's got to be a process, there's going to be something that's there.
Well, between Thomas and I, the biggest thing is they have trust in us. And we had one of them on stage the other day at our conference, and Thomas was interviewing him. He said, look, I just, they go, what's your success? He said, I just ring Matt Thomas when we're off track to tell me what I really need to do. Because he'll outlist me and Thomas at a listing. We can't teach him how to do that, right? We can't teach him to make, he knows what to do. It's about keeping rubber on the road with him, isn't it, Tom? Really. Keep the distractions away. We liken ourselves in this business to an airport, right? You guys are the jets. You guys are the jumbo jets. We make sure you take off well. Make sure you cruise at the right altitude. You don't get too high, don't get too low. Let you blow the windows out and you come in for a safe landing every time. That backup support coaching, that's the best way for me to run. Take off safe, cruising altitude, just tweak it. Make sure the windows don't blow out. There's no rough riding, you know. Yeah. And when you go up a bit higher, when you go up, you're in a plane, you keep going up, what happens? It starts getting a bit rocky. We just help you level that out, right? And then come in for a safe landing, right? And just continue. If you can keep doing that, you're going to keep flying right. Because that's really what an agent is. Our job to clear the runway, is what I'm trying to say, right? Clear that runway. Noise, road noise, you know, marketing, back, whatever it is that's blocking, clear it.
The biggest thing with the top riders is that a lot of people spend a lot of time trying to fix up the things that they're not good at. The challenge is you start fixing up a lot of things you're not good at, you just by saying you're good at a lot of things. Rather than finding out what you're really good at, enhancing it, and then finding someone else to do things you're not good at. And that's what all our best agents do. So that's different for different people. Some people hit the phones really well. That's awesome. Some people don't hit the phones really well. They're very good at network. That's awesome too. Some people are very, very good at marketing. Some people aren't. It just depends on what you're good at. Do it really well and find someone else to do the stuff that you're not good at.
That's gold. That's probably one of the best things that's going to come out today, my first interview. It's just delegate everything else that you're not good at and just do the best. But what you've got to own and take responsibility is do the best at what you're best at and make sure you own that. If you're the best lifter, but you're not a good closer, maybe team up with one of your other colleagues to close. Or, you know, if you're not good at doing pests and buildings, but my view is anything that's not dollar productive, you guys shouldn't be touching it. You should have a go and hire an assistant on 50k, 30k, 20k.
You can share the resource.
Share the resource. Three of you get one person and share it and get them to do everything that's non-dollar productive. I don't want to see anyone ever cutting a team here anymore and dropping my back to the owner. I don't want to see you doing a pest and building inspection ever again. I don't want to see you doing a photo shoot. This thing is one of the top agents in Brisbane that Thomas and I recruited years ago. I think their names. They sat down and said, oh, I'm very proud. I do all my photo shoots. I said, all right, that's great. What do you do? Oh, the owner loves seeing me now. I said, really? I said, do you think the owner loves seeing you there? What if I was the owner and I'm thinking, now my agent is here wasting 2 hours while they should be out there finding a buyer.
Where are our buyers?
I said that to her. She looked at me, she hasn't ever thought about it. I said, well, have a look. Let's do how many of you do 100 sales a year there? Yeah, no problem. So how long does it take you to photo shoot? 2 hours? If you said this to the vendor, look, you know me, I'm just gonna come in, introduce Thomas, he's gonna do the photo shoot, he's the best in photos. I'm going back to the office to ring the buyers and I'm gonna give you 4 reports this afternoon. You've just bought yourself 2 hours times 100 over 12 months. What does that look like in your world? Do you need to be there for the pest and building? Half an hour to drive there, 2 hours for the pest and building. Just say they run late, another half an hour. Now I drive, but you've lost 3 hours for a pest and building inspection. But you're not going to change the outcome of, oh, I need to be there, I'm going to tell the builder. As soon as you start doing that, the builder marks it worse. Have you ever noticed that?
Yeah.
Or the value up. No, but there's hours upon hours upon hours. We cut our agents' arms off and argue with them, the hands are fierce if there are any of those appointments. Because while they're not there, they're not listening and telling.
It's like settlements.
Settlements.
I'm not an attorney at all, yeah. Solicitor at all. I do not tell my solicitor to my answer how to settle a problem.
Yeah,
that is settlement. That's his task.
Yeah.
If I picked up my, spoke to my solicitor, Michael, and started telling him how to do it,
yeah, he'll start telling you how to sell.
Yeah, exactly.
And the other thing is, like, what we do recommend, though, the pre-settlement inspection, when you hand the keys over, go to the property and do the big full tour and hand them over and book yourself an appointment for 12 months ahead to come back and do a reappraisal at that point in time.
Mm-hmm.
You hear what I just said?
Yes.
If you do 50 sales a year, you've just made yourself 50 reappointments to do 50 appraisals next year. If you do that 4 times every year, yourself, if you've got 200 appraisals in 4 years' time.
This is a big problem, guys. If you go down to BMWs down the road here and you go and buy the car, when you buy it, what are they doing? They're going to need a full tour, like we need you for an extra 20 minutes. It's showing exactly where things are. Now, if something happens on the way out, make sure you ring me. This is happening here.
How to put petrol in here.
We've got a full tank of petrol in there for you. It's okay. Yeah, us as agents selling some of the biggest asset. We said, meet me at the cafe, I'll be keys ready, just come pick them up for me or whatever it might be. Sometimes you leave the key, they leave the keys in an envelope, stick it in the letterbox.
Oh.
But no, seriously, we all laugh. This stuff happens.
And agents that have got offers of the worst, they're down the pub where their new purchase is picking the keys up out to the office. They can't park, they've got a removal that's waiting. What about if you took a beautiful bottle of champagne down with a nice candle and a free meal for tonight's meal on the day they moved in down to the local pizzeria or shop or something that you did a deal with. That's what I do. I do deals everywhere. The market deals. Coffee club, there you go. What about comes up? Here's a coffee club. Here you've got the card. Right? It's better.
The big thing on this guy as well is that one recent very big property we sold, the agent didn't do this. And the buyer got to the property and it was literally filthy. This person just spent $5 million on a property and it was filthy. And it was a big wake up call to this agent. I said, do you think that person's going to send you into anywhere in the next 12 months or ever? No. I said, how much does that cost you? Yes, you made. Yeah. You made $100,000 from that sale. Sweet. But you just cost yourself $1 million.
100%.
Big problem.
So, how would you change your pre settlement? Your settlement day on that beautiful bottle of champagne you turn up with. Coffee club meal for two for tonight because I know you can't cook. All the keys photocopied on a piece of paper with this is the front door key, letterbox key, da da da. A showing on where the hot water system turns off, the garbage nights when it's coming, the alarm code walking through, how to turn on the air conditioner. You then having someone there, potentially if you've got an assistant, they can finish the minutiae. But book, hand the gift and leave. That's what I used to do.
hand the gift and my 50 hits and run through all the minutia. Then I'd leave and then I'd say, look, I'm popping, get your calendar out. You bought a house on the 19th of August to, on the first week of August next year, I'm going to call you and I'm going to come back and reappraise it for you, let you know what the market's doing. I'm going to come back every 12 months for the rest of your life. You think I'll lose that listing again? Never. Because they think they've got their agent. They go out to an open house. I know we're right with our agent. That's coming over next week.
Mm.
That's what happens, right? Mm. How many agents tell probably never speak to the buyer again, then kick their can on the way out when they see him come up with Ray White, thinking, oh, I can't believe they were disloyal. They didn't give me the outback. Mm. Huh? What did you do to her? What's the right? You think you sell someone and say you're going to get it back. Is that changing a bit of mindset? Yeah? If we do half of this stuff that was on this screen today, I personally believe you could double your income, just half of it. It's scary if you do the lot. Because it's not, there's no, if anything I said there you're not heard before, no. And it's real stuff. This is taken from agents that are actually doing this, that we've coached, mentored, tested, implemented, done it myself, mind you. I'm an agent, been selling for 20 years, you know. That's it. All right.
Thanks for your time, everyone.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. We're going to be here for a while, so we'll just hang around with any questions one-on-one.
Gracias.